Hi and welcome back to my channel. So I'm super excited about today's travel video. I have two things that I want to share with you guys today. But before I jump right on in, I just want to say thank you so much to all my subscribers and to my newest subscribers. Thank you so very much for stopping by and choosing to follow me. Love you guys dearly, and I thank you so much for continuing to support me and all that I do. So let's jump right on in. So today I'm going to be talking about how to build a classic travel wardrobe. Now I got this idea as I was going through Pinterest a couple of days ago, and a woman by the name of Alex Capsule, she posted this article about things that women should have, that every woman should have when they're packing for travel. And so I thought, oh, this is very fitting. It's very unique and very interesting, things that I hadn't even thought about. And I also decided I wanted to do it because I'm one of these people that I always forget something when I'm packing. Not intentionally, it's just that, you know, I think I have everything and then I get where I'm going, or I'm in the midst of going where I'm trying to get to, and I think, oh, you know what, I didn't pack this, I didn't pack that. So packing to travel can be a little frustrating. Fun for some, frustrating for others. So let's jump right on in and let's see what Miss Alex has to say about females and packing. So coats and jackets need to be the very most versatile. So it's very important that you find something that you will love wearing and that will look good with everything that you pack. I absolutely agree with that. So she says every female should only pack one of these per trip, just one. A black blazer, a khaki trench, a leather jacket, a utility jacket, or honorable mention, a denim jacket. Okay? So, like I said, she says you only need to pack one. I'm pretty sure some of us have packed more than one, but she says you only need to pack one. So, comfort is key when it comes to selecting your bottoms. Keeping in mind, they need to be comfortable. You will need these every time that you travel. Okay? Now, here are the classic styles every female traveler should own. Dark wash skinny jeans, straight leg denim, neutral maxi, denim shorts, black leggings, and cotton shorts. Let me put a pin right there because I don't know if you've ever seen me in public, and as we go, actually during the month of December, some of my videos, I'm actually going to be standing up for a change because I'm always sitting down. But if you've ever seen me from the waist down, then you know that skinny jeans is a no-no, okay? Because I have hips, I have thighs, and the good Lord has seen fit to bless me with booty. So skinny jeans is not going to work for me at all. But if it works for you, awesome. Straight leg jeans, also a no-no. When you have hips, the worst thing you can do is wear straight leg jeans because they make your hips look even wider. So I always wear jeans with kind of a flared leg because it, you know, just balances out my body. What else? Leggings. Not really a leggings kind of person, but you know, if that works for you, then have at it. But nonetheless, these are some great tips, and that's why I'm sharing them. So now, it's always best to limit your shoes to 3 pair when you travel. I agree on this because they take up so much space. So if you try to load your suitcase down with shoes to match every outfit that you have, number one, you're going to run out of space. But secondly, that suitcase is going to become heavy very quickly. So the key is to wear a pair and pack the other two. These classic shoes will keep you comfortable for a wide range of destinations. Flip-flops, sneakers, ballet flats, slip-ons, sandals, and flat boots. Now, I am in 100% agreement with all of these. Now, let's move on to tops. Your tops will vary depending on your preference and where you're going. Quality tees and all of the neutral colors are a good idea, and you probably should get them in long and short sleeves, sleeveless, and the 3/4 length. I agree with that, and I do have tees in pretty much every color you can think of, in every variation, long, short, sleeveless, and 3/4 length as well. So here are the essential tops that should be in every woman's travel wardrobe. A striped shirt, a white button-down, a gray tee, a black tunic, and an oatmeal tank. Now, last but certainly not least are the dresses, where you get, and this is where you get style, femininity, and simplicity all in one package. It's recommended that you look for neutral colors, but since they don't have to be combined with other clothing, you can select bolder colors if you like. And I am all for bold colors myself. So, here are the options that you can and probably should have in your wardrobe. A shirt dress, a t-shirt dress. Now, let me put a pin right here, because when I saw that, I thought, what in the world is a t-shirt dress? So of course I had to Google it. And basically, you know how you have tank tops? Well, it's just a whole dress with the top that kind of that looks like a tank top. So I was like, okay, cool, I have some of those. Now you want a fit and flared dress. And the best way I can describe this is to think of an A-line dress. Again, if you're like me and you have hips, A-line dresses are absolutely perfect for you. And then you want shift styles, loose and not form-fitted ones, okay? So those have been, and I'm gonna make sure I link all this information in the description box so that you don't have to worry about trying to take notes or remember what I said. But I thought these were just really good ideas about, you know, things to put in my wardrobe, which actually is gonna be great because this week coming up, as you know, is Thanksgiving. And so the day after Thanksgiving, I'm headed out of town. And so I'm going to be using these tips as I pack for my weekend trip. So thank you, Miss Alex Capsule, for these wonderful, wonderful suggestions on how to pack. I truly appreciate it. Now, going into my next travel-related thing that I want to share with you, this just came into my email a couple of days ago, as a matter of fact, and it's the Winterfest of Lights. And if you're like me, I've been to Ocean City thousands of times, more times than I can even count, but I have never ever gone down to see the Winterfest of Lights. This is actually something that I have on my list of things that I'm thinking about doing, because I do have the last 2 weeks in December off, as I do every year. So I think I'm going to take a drive down, spend the night, and just go check this out firsthand. So the email starts out, it says, join us this holiday season and experience Winterfest of Lights, Ocean City's award-winning lights festival. Bring the whole family and enjoy more than 1 million sparkling holiday lights and hundreds of animated light displays throughout the Northside Park. Relax and sip hot chocolate. Let me put a pin right there. Anytime you say relax and sip hot chocolate, I'm in, because I love me some hot chocolate. And the heated Winterfest Village Pavilion. Take a photo with Santa and board the Winterfest Express to tour fairy tale themed exhibits. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that sounds so interesting to me. Now, here is their schedule of events. So, November the 17th through January the 1st is the Avenue of Trees. November the 19th, Light Up Downtown Festival. Also on the 19th, there's a Turkey Trot Golf Open. November 24th through the 27th is Thanksgiving weekend, of course. November 25th through the 27th, Holiday Shoppers Fair. November 25th through the 27th as well is the Delmarva Wool and Fiber Expo. December the 3rd, and also my dad's birthday, is Ocean City's Christmas Parade. Also on December 3rd, the Celtic Yuletide. December 3rd through the 4th, 10th, 11th, 17th, 18th, and the 24th, Horse and Carriage Rides with Santa. December the 4th, Ocean City Winterfest of Lights 5K. December 7th, Pizza with Santa. December 11th, A Christmas Cabaret. December the 18th, The Nutcracker. December the 31st, New Year's Eve Fireworks. January 1st, Mayor and City Council's Annual Open House. And January 1, there is going to be a penguin swim. Now, I don't know about you guys, but the thought of jumping in cold water does not sound very pleasing to me. But if you are brave, then come on out on, what did I say, January the 1st for the Penguin Swim, and I'm pretty sure that you will have a wonderful time. So that is all I have to share with you guys. Thank you so very much for, as I said, for always supporting me in all that I do. And I hope something that I shared with you today resonates with you and you decide to go and rethink your holiday packing or head on down to Ocean City to check out the Winterfest of Lights. And I think that is going to be it for today's travel news. And I look forward to seeing you guys next week. I love you guys tremendously. Have a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. Just love on your families because you know what? People can be here today and gone tomorrow. So again, have a wonderful Thanksgiving and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.